Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Hardcore Ironman Chronicles. It's been 11 months since the last episode in this series. It's a bit ridiculous, but honestly, I don't play on this account much because it cuts into time from more important things. But we had the free membership this past 2 weeks from Twitch, and I made use of it on this account to get a few important things done. First of all, obviously I did gain myself some archaeology up to level 42 from level 20, which was the original limit beforehand. But there is more than that that I got done, obviously. Let me find... Here we go. Okay, I've got the list of what my skills were at before this 2 weeks, or at least in the last episode, and we can kind of see what's happened. First of all, I was at 116 quest points in the last episode. I'm now at 158. I did a bunch of key quests this time around. I did Underground Pass, I did Regicide, I did the Trinome Stronghold quest, I did Monkey Madness, I did Ishlaren's Little Helper, I did Troll Romance, Edgar's Ruse. There's a whole bunch of important quests setting up for doing some important things. I was actually going to do Desperate Times and Contact, but I ran out of time, and specifically for Desperate Times. In a twist of fate, I actually need Runite Stone Spirits and have trouble getting them on this account right now because my combat level is so low. I was trying to fight some mature grot worms last minute, but they only have a 7% chance of dropping one, and I need two, and it just didn't work out last night. So that's where we made it on quests. A lot closer on my goals towards Dominion Tower. I need to have 20 specific quests done in order to access Dominion Tower, and we are more than halfway now, and have made good progress in getting the requirements towards the other quests that we need. It's mostly just an issue of getting around to it. Oh yeah, I guess one other quest I forgot to mention was Fairy Tale Part 2. That's not to say those are all the quests I did. I did a few other random ones in there, but that is the main ones I can think of. Oh, well, I guess I did Smoking Kills as well. For those Slayer point doubling, which is nice. But yeah, so that's the questing I did. I went from 73 to 86 combat. We now have 60 in defense, which is pretty nice. Can actually wear some decent armor if I can actually find it. Of course, being a hardcore Iron Man, that's not always so easy. Prayer only went up 2 levels. It's not big. I'm not really focused on prayer because once I get Dominion Tower, that's where my prayer is going to come from. So that has been a very small focus. Magic, I gained 2 levels just because it's so high level and I didn't do that much combat. And I was kind of focused on melee because my melee was pretty bad. I was only 50 attack at the start of this. And very low defense too. I think it was 48 defense. Runecrafting, I didn't do much. I think it might have been Tears of Guthix mostly that got me runecrafting experience. Construction, I gained a decent amount of levels. I was 49, now I'm 56. Dungeoneering, 63 to 68. It's not bad. Dungeoneering is one of the prep requirements, so that's part of why I was doing that. Just also, I got a Bone Crusher. I gotta remember that. Which is pretty nice. I hope to get enough points to get it on the tool belt next time around. Agility, I put a good amount of effort into agility because, for one thing, I was doing Hunter for skill Chompas, and obviously higher agility is better doubling chance or whatever for skill Chompas. So I did that. Also, 56 is the Regicide requirement. And also, I wanted to be able to get around Anachronia a little better, so I was working on that. Herblore, I didn't do much actual Herblore training, but I did dump, like, Troll Invasion and stuff into that. So that's why that has gone up a decent amount. I'm not sure how much. I think I AFK'd some event in Herblore as well, so I can't say how many of these levels came from actual play in this 2 weeks and how much was just whatever happened in the past 11 months. But thieving, I definitely did a lot of. We were at 40 last episode. Got all the way up to 55 this time around. I was doing gullible tourists or something. Whatever they're called. Not the gullible tourists. I was thinking about doing the gullible tourists. It was the Minifos marketeer people. Whatever they are. I was spamming them. Get a little bit of reputation at Minifos, and some important requirements and stuff done there. Crafting, obviously, I was working on crafting for invention. Wasn't in a huge rush to get to 80, since the other two skills, I'm not at 80 yet. Not even close. So I just kind of inched forward there. I did the clan citadel to get bonus XP. And, you know, just gained a couple levels. I think I was at 77 or 76 when it started. Fletching, I didn't really do much fletching at all. I did like a daily challenge or two to gain levels in that. I don't know, I really think I should do woodcutting and fletching, at least to the point where I hit woodcutting 75 when I'm free to play. Whether or not I actually do that, I don't know, but I really feel like that's what I should be doing. Slayer, yeah, I did a fair amount of Slayer. It's kind of a struggle on this account because, you know, you get crappy tasks from Vanica, or you get tasks that are too hard from Shaldar. So, yeah. I mean, I wasn't in any specific rush to get Slayer. I wanted Slayer 55 because that's the requirement for Big Game Hunter, but I knew I wasn't going to get to Big Game Hunter this time around either, so yeah. I did do a lot of hunting, though. That was, I think, my biggest individual skill gain was in Hunter. I'm not sure what it was at before. I was 35 in the last episode. I believe I must have been higher than that. I don't know, maybe I was 35. Point is, I'm 58 now, which is pretty decent. Not sad at all with that. Divination went from the 30s up to level 50, which is a desperate times requirement, but also just, you know, a level I decided to stop at. It's also for shifting tombs, which I did do a lot of shifting tombs. You can unlock the desert pantheon aura from that nowadays, and I was working towards that, and I got pretty close. In fact, once I end this episode, I might spend the last minutes of my time with membership, because I have until 1504 for membership. But yeah, you see, you get 50 for each trip if you do it properly, so, you know, I'm not that far away from finishing up the Desert Pantheon aura. It was a good way to get a little bit of XP and a variety of skills. And also, Minifos reputation, I'm up to level 4. For the general Minifos stuff, which is not bad. I do have the relic from Archaeology that gives you a 10% reputation boost as well. For farming, too. I didn't gain any farming tiers, though, but got pretty close. I just unlocked the ability to breed in the medium pens this morning, I think. Yeah, at like 1 a.m. this morning. It was a struggle, just having the cows and the rabbits. But now, finally, my sheep can grow, I guess. Anyway, enough about that. Mining smithing, gained a little bit there. I was at 58 on both of those beforehand. Obviously, I needed to make my ore calcite armor when I got the level. I had to make mattocks and stuff, so that is basically how that came about. I also did a lot of the Dorks and Borks mini-quest things, so that helped with that. The whole Gophanon bonus XP and stuff. Fishing and cooking, didn't really do too much on cooking, but fishing, I guess I got a decent amount. I forget why I needed fishing. I needed it for something, but yeah. Not a big gain there. Same with woodcutting and fire making. Those were not my focus at all. I kind of AFK'd a little bit of woodcutting one day, but, you know, whatever. Farming, obviously I was doing this. Gained a few farming levels there. I was 49 the last episode, so it was no huge gains. It'll be better the next time around now that I can finally have them breed in this pen. And we'll be able to do some things. I don't have any spare beans saved up, though. I also did get some frogs, I think, over in... Is it frogs or is it salamanders? One of the two. Over in the Anachronia one, but I can't breed with them yet, so... They're kind of just sitting there, doing nothing until I can afford the either the breeding pen or the... I don't think I can build the breeding pen, actually. I think it has a higher construction cost, so... Yeah, but... Yeah, I have to buy that upgrade over there, too. It's separate, sadly, for breeding in the small pens over in the dinosaur land. And then finally, of course, there is summoning. I didn't do any actual summoning training. I did have Tears of Guthix give some XP into it. This last week, So that gained it, I think, 3 or 4 levels. Something like that. I mean, summoning is definitely not a priority at all. It would have been nice to get all my levels 50 plus, but at least we're 40 plus, with most being 50 plus now. So yeah, that is kind of where the levels are at. Like I mentioned, we did gain Minifos reputation. I worked on Anachronia, pretty close to maxing out everything on there that I can do at my current level. We don't have all the workers, but other than that, it's, you know, we got pretty much everything saved up that we can buy without gaining additional levels. And I guess I should show my bank. I was kind of hoping something would grow here to show off during this actual episode. I got a lot of jackalopes, I will say that. Does it actually track how many jackalopes you have done? I'm not sure. We can find out, though. What does this do? Just, I have a jackalope? Oh, it just says you have successfully bred a jackalope. Okay, that's boring. Yeah, like, this is a jackalope, that's a jackalope. I sold at least 3 jackalopes, too. So, yeah, I don't know why, but all of a sudden I just got a million jackalopes all in a row. It was insane randomness luck, but I guess that's what you expect for an Iron Man, right? Oh yeah, I pulled the mush from the rabbits because I'm not breeding them anymore. Probably pull it from the other pens too, so I can save it. Got some clue scrolls that I need to do. That's probably smart. You know, what else did we get? I'll say I got the Bone Crusher, saving up for that. Got a Willow composite bow, which is completely useless, but I could, I don't know, sell it. You can trade items to main accounts, so, you know, maybe I'll do that. I got mass earmuffs now, which is pretty good. Oh yeah, there's another jackalope right there. I think that was my first jackalope. And then the other two were just ones that I kept for whatever reason. I don't really remember why I kept a few of my jackalopes, but I did. And this is what my bank looks like. There's nothing particularly special in it. It's an Iron Man account bank, obviously. Kind of unorganized because I didn't really care. I have a steel ceremonial sword because I do. Oh yeah, I got a Bob shirt as well. I should really probably just get rid of some of these. Not like I'm ever going to use any of them. Just taking up bank space. I didn't really focus much on archaeology like I thought I would, just because, you know, getting all the way to a level to get another useful relic seemed like a lot of work. Because some of the useful ones, like getting the item to combine it with, would be a bit annoying, and then others, I just don't see the point. Like, I might have done this one, but I would have to actually get an Onyx first. And that's just not going to happen in this 2 weeks. So yeah, I think that's basically it. I'm kind of struggling to think of anything else to discuss about this account. In total, back in July last year, I was at total level 1,269. Now I'm at 1,546, which is a pretty decent jump for an account that I barely touch, in my opinion. I don't know when they'll do another free membership thing, so I don't know when we'll get our next actual episode on this. I'm actually considering, once I start streaming, that maybe I will actually buy membership on this account and stream that. It seems like it'd be fun, now that this account's kind of getting stronger and actually able to do a few things. Maybe it'd be fun to stream it. And then we can, like, stream quests and stuff, which is something I normally can't do because I'm recording episodes for quests. So that could be a fun thing. And, you know, just doing general training and stuff, things that I wouldn't normally do on the main account in any real quantity, like shifting tombs for that chance at that offhand tier 82 weapon, which I sadly did not get, even though I opened a lot of those chests. It's a 1 out of 800 chance, but I'm not that lucky. But yeah, I think I have wasted enough time discussing this account here. My animals are probably going to miss me, but that is their life. They are going to starve to death, and then I'll come back and feed them when I'm finally a member again. So yeah, that is the IronKaBob Hardcore Ironman Chronicles. Maybe someday I'll bother actually changing this account back to a male. It's from that one quest recruitment drive. I've just never bothered to change it back. I kind of like having it to where I can easily tell that this isn't my main account if I get distracted. Wouldn't want to come back and forget that I was playing on my Iron Man for a second and die. So, I've not bothered to change it. It's kind of weird, though. I mean, it's not really weird, it's just people think it's weird. If you play as a girl, they're like, oh, you're trying to show off. No, I'm literally just lazy. But I kind of like not having to worry quite so much about forgetting which account it is. The only thing that catches me off guard is the noises your character makes when you get hurt. That always catches me off guard with this account. But maybe that's a good thing, since I don't actually want to take unexpected damage. So yeah, it's unexpected strategy thanks to recruitment drive there. And me being lazy and not wanting to spend a very small amount of money to change back. I don't even know if Makeover Mage costs money anymore. But anyway, that is quite a tangent there. So anyway, yeah, I'll see you guys whenever this account gets active again. Who knows how long that'll be. Bye.